question of treating other people with some degree of justice and rule of law finally went out of the window and was demolished in the 1860s over Morenbe. You know, from then on we knew that the empire was about ruling people with the maximum degree of coercion.
Some of the new ideas about race in the High Victorian Age drew their evidence from the world of the dead. Based on the study of corpses and skeletons, the burgeoning science of anatomy laid the foundations for a new scientific racism. In Britain, the most important race scientist was a now-forgotten Edinburgh surgeon. Ruined by a body-snatching scandal in the 1820s, he had fled Britain in disgrace. But in the 1840s, Dr. Robert Knox resurfaced with the publication of a new book.
Race is everything. Literature, science, art, in a word, civilization depends on it.
For Robert Knox in that book, race is everything. It determined your character, it determined your position in civilization, it determined your destiny.
Can the black races become civilized? I should say not.
He saw racial conflict and extermination happening all around the world. It was natural for him to believe that racial types were bound to struggle and that the superior races would dominate the naturally inferior ones.
The Saxon race will never tolerate them, never amalgamate, never be at peace. It is a war of extermination. One or other must fall.
Robert Knox was not a lone voice. In America, a group led by the renowned craniologist Samuel George Morton had begun to collect the skulls of different races and compare them.
Skulls were chosen to be measured because it was reckoned that the skull was the container of the most important part of the human body, the brain. The bigger the skull, the bigger the brain. The shape of the skull, the shape of the brain.
The American School of Race Scientists concluded that the races, as measured through their skulls, were so different as to be separate species. Tasmanians, Africans, American Indians were not the lower races of men. They were perhaps not fully human at all.